Thank you all for joining this session. This is a session after lunch. I hope I'm able, I will be able to keep you awake. Tech talks are not so common in investment conferences. Thank you. I must thank Manav for creating a session for Tech Talk. And Manav is himself a supporter of the fact that technology, especially guest-facing technology, is vital to enhancing guest experiences in hotels. Media these days has been abuzz with a lot of stories around hotels announcing their plan or about rooms of future. Someone calls it smart rooms, someone calls it connected rooms. And if you see all of the, if you track all of these media, it is evident that hotels are now realizing that technology or guest room technology will probably be driving the design, the philosophy of rooms in future. If you see some of these news clips, you will see some jargons like Internet of Things and smart rooms and connected rooms, and a lot of people get confused as to what does this mean, and this is exactly what we're going to talk and understand in this session. So I would say, to make it very simple, I would say all of these things eventually mean the same thing. They can, they can be used interchangeably. Internet of Things, as you can see, there are only two words, things and internet. And what are these things? Things could be anything that you see in the guest room, starting from a door lock to lights to thermostat to curtains to television to minibar to electric safe to even a shower. And internet here means inter-network, which simply means connecting these devices or connecting these things. Now, here I want to tell you that internet here in context of hotels does not necessarily mean the internet that we use for browsing or banking or checking emails. And why I'm emphasizing this here is because two things. One is people do have fear of exposing things in a hotel directly to the internet because of the risks associated with exposure to internet. And they're rightful in thinking so. And why is this confusion? Because Internet of Things in the consumer space that you see and hear more about in the media or everywhere is more often cloud-driven. They are normally served using internet services. However, in hospitality world, it works very differently and does not necessarily have to be connected to internet. So I just wanted you to be aware that Internet of Things in the consumer space for your homes is very different from what you will, what you would want to do in a hotel space. Now, when you say Internet of Things, what does it essentially mean? When you say a lock or a light, or what does it, what does it, what qualifies it to become Internet of Things? The first thing is, of course, it needs to be connected. You need to have a path to reach. You need to have some mode of communication to reach to that thing. It could be wired. It could be wireless. On wireless, you have competing technologies like Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, ZigBee, Z-Wave, LoRa, so many competing technologies. You need an address. Of course, you need an address to reach anything. So like any place in the physical world, so you also need an address for that thing, to reach that thing. Now, once you have an address and once you have a path, what is it that it's going to serve? What is it going to give it to you? So what it brings, first of all, is status. And why do we need status? We send a WhatsApp message and then wait for the two ticks to turn blue to give us a status that it has been read by your wife or husband or your boss. So status is important for us to know whatever we have communicated has actually reached or what is the status of that device. The other thing is about controls. And we need, imagine if there was a television without a remote control, so you had to walk up all the time to the television to change the channel or up the volume. Now, of course, with remote control, you can control it with a distance. So likewise, control in this world just simply means that you could control from a distance, whether within the room or from thousands of miles. And analytics. Now, this is very, very important, and I'm going to cover this again, why analytics is important. Analytics is important to make business decisions, and analytics is always based on statistical information. So once things start giving us information, we can make important decisions, and I'm going to come to that later on. Now, that was all the theory that I wanted to talk in my presentation today, and now we're going to get real as to when we talk about connected things in a hotel, what are we going to expect? What can we do that with that? And there are many, many examples, many, many use cases, and I'm going to cover some and few so that you know how different hotels may want to use this technology to improve their guest experience. So let me start with a very simple thing in a guest room. Let's say, like a lock. What does a lock do? It has a very simple function. It opens the door lock with a valid key, and it does not open the lock with an invalid key. That is the all the function of a door lock. So when you want to make the lock as a connected lock or smart lock or IoTized lock, you send that lock to an IoT college, what will that lock do for you? Okay. It can do. So when the guest arrives to the room after the check-in and opens the door, the lock can whisper this to the connected friends in the room. And what they're going to do is, with this information, they will orchestrate a welcome scene for the guest. And let's see a small video, which will probably give you an indication of what I'm trying to talk to you about. So the guest is arriving into the room. He opens the door. The lock has whispered this to the thermostat. The thermostat is now changing to a cooling mode. And now the curtains are opening to create a welcome scene for the guest. And now you see the lights slowly coming up to create a full welcome scene into the room. So now you see, just by adding some intelligence to the lock, we can create a much, much elevated welcome scene into the room. And what else can a lock do if you make it smarter? Imagine I'm staying in this hotel for 3 days, and I lose my key card somewhere here on the floor. Of course, I can reach out to the front office, and they'll be happy to issue me a duplicate key. But the problem is that the original key is still valid. And if it falls in wrong hands, it still has a risk. It's a risk for me. And the poor lock cannot help me here. But if it's a connected lock, the situation could be different. So I reach to the front office saying that I lost my key. They will issue me another duplicate key, but this will be communicated to the lock automatically. And what the lock is going to do is that it's going to invalidate the previously issued key. So you see, just by making the lock connected, the lock has become a lot more smarter. Also, the lock can inform the maintenance that now I'm running out of battery, please energize me. So lock can, you know, make a lot of difference in terms of once you have connected well. So that was a small example of how one small thing can make a lot of difference in hotel operations. And there are so many such examples which I'm not going to cover now. But let's see how different hotels are using such, you know, what are their plans, what are the roadmaps in terms of embracing such technology to improve their rooms of future. So Marriott, as you would have heard yesterday from Mr. Sorensen here, their focus is all about customizing the guest stay. And the central theme to the customization is based out of their Marriott loyalty program. So what they're trying to do is, within the Marriott loyalty program, they're trying to create the golden profile of their guests, where it stores your preferences. And using those preferences, they want to set the temperature in the room based on your preference. They want to change the digital art in the room based on your art preferences, or maybe they can show you your family pictures and things like that. Or also, they plan to bring up, let's say, targeted promotions on the television. So if I'm a if I like golfing, probably on the television in my room, it shows me information about golfing activities around the hotel, rather than showing me things like spa and things like, you know, bar, which I'm not probably keen about. So their whole journey about the rooms of future is about personalization. Hilton. Hilton has taken a different path here. They want to make the H Honors app as a key to the guest journey. And within the H Honors app on your smartphone, they want to bring room controls like lights, thermostats, and television using their app. Accor has taken a different path. They have a lot of focus on accessibility. Of course, that's why they're designing adjustable beds, adjustable showers, and also in their luxury brands, they are embracing to bring in tablets into the room, which is connected to the entire ecosystem for a lot of services. Now, a lot of times I do hear, especially, you know, when technology meets hospitality, that technology will eventually try to make a distance between the personalized touch. Hospitality is all about human touch, personal touch. I've heard many times in conferences people saying that we want to remain low-tech, high-touch. Well, this may be true, but I'll give an example of how hotels which are known for services, hotels which are known for their hospitality, are embracing this to even improve where they are today, or where they have been there for decades. So what better example than Oberoi Hotels here in India? So everyone knows Oberoi Hotels for its legendary services, detailed to attention, and all of those things that Oberoi Hotels is known for. In the renovated, all new renovated New Delhi Hotel, they have used this technology to further enhance the guest experience, delight them, surprise them in many, many ways. And I'll share just one small example, or maybe a couple of examples. So they do have a complimentary use of movies on demand in the room, so the guests can watch movies on the television. So as the guest starts playing the movie on the television, the connected entertainment system whispers this to the butler. And what the butler does is, in a couple of minutes, he brings a complimentary bucket of popcorn to the guest. And the guests have been so delighted. It brings so much of joy because they feel that the hotel understands their needs. It fulfills the full cinematic experience in the hotel. You can go on the TripAdvisor and read the rave reviews that people have written about this small service that they added. Also, once the guest has had dinner or breakfast in the room, the in-room tablet prompts the guest if the guest would want the tray to be cleared. So small things just to add to the, you know, wonderful hospitality that Oberoi Hotels anyway has been doing for decades. It's just enhancing to the next level. I'll share another example of a new chain that's coming up in US. It's an urban luxury chain focused more around fitness and all of that. The name is still not announced, but I'll just share something that they're trying to do. So their focus is a lot about sleep and the wake-up experience. They want to improve the sleep experience using circadian lighting, which is human-centric lighting, because studies show that circadian lighting has impact on our sleep, and the right wake-up experience can have a very powerful impact on our mood day long. So what this hotel has done is that with use of color temperature changing lights, and with right use of dimmers, they create a near sunrise experience as the wake up alarm starts kicking in. And With the wake-up alarm, they also create some more experience into the room by playing some enchanting music and things like that. And I'll show you a small video of how it happens. This is a video that's been created there. So the guest is waking up, and the room is already playing enchanting music. The guest's eyelids are already dilated because of the sunrise experience in the room, and the coffee machine has already started brewing his favorite coffee. So you can use technology in many ways, which is closer to your concept of hospitality. So I just shared some few examples of how different brands are trying to embrace technologies across the globe. Now, we've seen some examples of the use cases of technology in this space. Now, people may ask that, does it bring in some tangible benefits to the operations or value to the operations? And yes, it does in many ways, and I'm not going to cover all of that, but just to touch upon, one of the important things that it can bring is energy savings. As you all know, air conditioning is probably the most energy-consuming service in the room, and with use of, a lot of hotels, thermostat is just a wall piece hung onto the wall, but the moment you try to make it smarter, it can bring in anywhere between 15 to 25% of energy savings. Of course, thermostats can know when the rooms are unoccupied and can bring them to a comfort mode, thereby saving energy. They can also whisper this to the curtains, and the blackout curtains can actually come down during the daytime when the guest is not inside the room, and it's a huge prevention of energy loss because you lose a lot of energy from the large windows that you create, and during the day, they are all open. So you can creatively use all of these technologies while trying to create a guest excitement, silently use them for bringing more value to your operations. Likewise, it can also bring in manpower savings. A very small sensor, probably cost-effective, doesn't cost you so much, if you put on the door of the minibar, can produce a report how many minibars in the last 24 hours were just not opened, which means they don't need refilling. It can actually bring in 50% of manpower on just refilling of the minibars. This is just one small example. Likewise, lamps, when they go bust, they can automatically report to maintenance that they need a change, or locks can also indicate. So there are many such examples where systems automatically can report their status, and it can bring in and manpower efficiency. The last thing which I was telling earlier also about analytics. Now, analytics, we need analytics in business to take business decisions. And analytics must be based on some statistics. Of course, hoteliers do take feedback in terms of TripAdvisor, in terms of follow-up mails, in terms of meeting the guests in the lobby to take their feedback. But they are mostly in qualitative in nature. They represent 5 to 10% of the guests. They don't really represent, and they are again based on the mood of the guest and very qualitative in nature. The moment you have connected things, they can start logging the usage. And when coupled with information like the guest profile or the time of the usage or the demographic information, you can create very, very powerful reporting. This is just one example of a report that we created for a hotel that's very high on energy saving and reducing carbon footprint for itself as well as for its guests. So it just shows you, how many guests have been in the green zone and how many guests have been in the red zone and all of that. Of course, this is a 25,000 feet report, and then you keep zooming in to get details down to the last room. So of course, with analytics, we can create a lot of, and these analytics will actually help hotels decide how to shape up their rooms. And I'm going to share you an example of a hotel, an island resort that we opened last year. And of course, the owners are very forward-looking owners. And the opening general manager said, we don't probably need a Netflix in this hotel because this is a very different place. You don't understand, because people come here to forget the world, walk on the serene beach, and all of that. But of course, finally, the Netflix feature was there. And with this analytics, we were able to show that the Netflix usage on this island resort was actually the highest we've ever seen in the world. So you could see that sometimes the perception that you may have about guest behavior or guest expectation may be very different from reality. And let me tell you, this is not anything specific about a person, but please understand the generation gap, which earlier used to be 20 years, is actually changing in 5 years now. My two daughters are just 6 years. They have an age difference of 6 years, but the elder one believes that the younger one is a generation different. This is changing so fast that hoteliers don't realize how the guests, and this is the reason why you see brands like Citizen M come with a whole new thought, and everyone wants to probably get into a philosophy like that, because it's a whole new generation which is responding to that kind of hotel. So analytics will help hotels decide how their rooms of future needs to be reshaped. And of course, as you get into new things, you may have certain experiences. You may have sometimes good, sometimes bad. So one always needs to avoid pitfalls. We have limited time here, but I'll just let you tell you that please avoid using consumer technologies in hotels. They're designed for homes. What works in a home does not necessarily work good in a hotel, because they may work well there. While a bedroom and a hotel room looks very similar, they have very, very different operational needs. So try using something which is designed for an enterprise application. Also try avoid getting into trap into buzzwords, or all of those words like smart, IoT, or all of those words. Just by adding smart to a television doesn't make it any smarter. Trust me, it doesn't make any smarter, especially in a hotel situation. It doesn't make it any smarter. So just by adding anything to the, to the product doesn't make it any smarter. You need to get it supported along with a lot of services, stitched into your operations, stitched into your, and you also need to know what do you really want to achieve out of, buying probably a smarter product. So with that, I come to the end of my session. And if there are any questions, I'm happy to answer. Otherwise, I'm available outside, and I'll be happy to engage one-on-one. I have maybe a couple of minutes, and maybe I can take a couple of questions, or I hope I've been able to keep you awake after this fantastic lunch that HVS would have, Hotelivate would have offered you. Good. Everyone has got the message. Message has been delivered. Thank you very much. Thank you for being such a lovely audience.